The majority of companies in Montenegro are small and medium enterprises, that is about 98% of the companies. And the most attractive sectors in Montenegro are now trade, tourism and construction sector, except that now we have a big development of the energy company and also IT sectors. The main barrier which we developed in 2014 for the companies supported by International Labour Organization regarding Montenegro are first regulatory framework, then lack of financial instruments, informal economy, corruption and mismatch between education and labor market. This is something that company recognized from the very past period in Montenegro, and during this period we try to improve situation in all of these aspects. Then regarding the information and consultation in Montenegro, it is defined by the labor law, and the labor law defined that employer should inform trade unions about the results of the doing business in the year, then development plans of the companies, and also the measure about improvement of working places and stuff like that. Except that employers should inform trade unions about occupation safety and healthy, implementation of new technologies, and if there is some plans to reduce the workforce in the company. Now, the working councils in Montenegro are not regulated by any regulations, so we don't have a specific law about working councils, and it will not be implemented until 2017. Regarding the opinion of social partner, we can say that employers are very interested for implementation of working councils in Montenegro, but on the other side, there is some problems and let's say negative attitude from the side of trade union because of the role of trade union and working council, which is not defined properly in Montenegro. And for sure, after 2017, there will be a space to implement working councils in Montenegro. As I mentioned before, one of the main barriers is mismatch between education system and labor market in Montenegro, and regarding that, additional education is necessary for employers to provide to employees if they want to have good employees in their companies. So that is not obligatory for the employers, but during the fact that employees don't have practical experience after the finishing school, employers in Montenegro realize that they really need to implement additional education sessions and trainings for the employees. So now the situation is improved, and in small companies that is still a problem because they don't have a budget for the education, but in big companies they often organize education for the employees, and in that they are trying to cover that lack of practical experience of the employees.